My name is Paul. I'm the associate pastor here at First Baptist Church, and I just want to welcome you to our facilities. When you came in, there were restrooms on your left and on your right. If those are full, you can go straight up, and there's the exact same restrooms up in our balcony. And so, because there's just four of them up there, you may need to plan ahead a little bit. Don't want you to have to wait too long. But we're so glad you're here. We're so thankful for Rodney Baucom and the Life FM for promoting this and doing this. Really, all we're doing is providing the room, and so it's exciting for us. So, Rodney, come on up here and introduce the band and talk about all the great things that you talk about. But we're so happy to have you here tonight.
And we're thankful for First Baptist Church Revival. How many of you are members here? A lot of you are, so you need to make sure that you embarrass all the other members that aren't here tonight. Tell them what we mean. Now, we're so thankful for this church, what you mean to this community, and for just opening up the doors and allowing us to put a good concert. We love bringing great gospel concerts to our listening area, and we're so thrilled about being here tonight. I'll never forget, and this, hopefully all of you have strong stomachs, but we got to tell a story. The last time we had a concert here, after it was over, it was dark. I mean, it was pitch dark leaving here, so I got behind another guy, and you know, it's two lanes on 81 going back toward Anderson, which is where I live, and so I noticed up ahead that there was a carcass on the road, some kind of something got hit, and it was a big carcass, and this car came up, so I decided to get in the middle lane, you know, get away from that carcass. This car comes zooming up beside me, did not see the carcass, runs right through it, and fills my car with all kind of
leftovers. Why is
it disgusting? I know, that was disgusting, right?
Right.
I thought I would start with that so the rest of the evening would be uphill.
Thank you.
It's an improvement.
Yeah.
So, but no, we're so happy that you are here and thrilled about the First Baptist Side for allowing us to be here tonight. Just wanted to mention a few things. We do have Gold City coming up again tomorrow night. If you feel like traveling over to Found In, they're going to be back over there at this wonderful church there, Pleasant Grove Baptist Church. So if you don't get a feel tonight, come on over there tomorrow night. We'll try to twist their arm into singing different songs maybe tomorrow night.
Yeah.
So there you go. And Reagan, we did want to tell them too about it.
Yes, I wanted to tell you guys about our app. So I know summer's coming up and a lot of you guys are going to be traveling. I know we're going on a little beach trip this summer. So if you want to bring the Life FM with you, we have these little flyers out at our table. And there are these little white boxes down here. They're called QR codes. And I know all of you guys are really cool, up to date with your iPhones, right? Do you guys have smartphones? A few of you do. So if you have a smartphone, you can just open your camera and you hold it on this little white box and a link will pop up. You click on it and then it'll take you to the App Store and you can download our Life FM app. And whenever you travel, you can listen to the Life FM anywhere you go. You won't get any static. You just connect it to your car and you're good to go. So that's what we'll be doing this summer when we're traveling. I hope you guys do it too. So pick up one of these flyers out of the table.
You really eased him into the QR code thing, right?
Yeah.
You were assuming we were all idiots, right?
No, well, you told me to explain that thoroughly, so I did. Did I do it?
Good job. All right, I want to give you two just a quick summary of our Life FM Share-a-thon. We finished that up about 2 weeks ago today, and we ended up at about 92% of the goal at that time when we finished the 3-day Share-a-thon. And as of today, we're at like 99.5% to being completely funded. And a guy tonight gave me a check to help a little bit more too. So we're with that included, we're just about $2,500 short of reaching 100%. So if anybody wants to hand me a check for $2,500 tonight, we'll run around the auditorium. All right, thank you so much for being here tonight. Let's go to the Lord in prayer, and then we're going to get started with Gold City. Lord, we love you, and we thank you for an opportunity that we have together in this place, Father. And Lord, we pray that it is more than a concert. Lord, we pray that tonight might be a time where we lay our burdens down, those burdens that we have, and we all have them. Lord, we pray that tonight might be a time of rejoicing, a time of fun, but God, also just a time and moments of praise that we bring our praises to you through this great quartet that we'll enjoy singing tonight, Father. Lord, we thank you so much for who they are, what they do, who they stand for, and the many miles that they travel to share the good news of Jesus. And Father, we lift that name up tonight, in the precious name of Jesus, and we make this prayer.
Amen.
All right, how many of you are quartet fans? How did I know the top quartet in all of gospel music these days? Would you help me welcome to Iowa, South Carolina, Gold City.
All right.
Amen.
I will be so.
Stadium.
I've always wanted to sing in Ivan. It's so good to be here. We are so thankful that you have come out on this Friday night to spend the evening with Gold City. We're going to have a great time. Y'all believe it's all right for God's people to have fun?
Yeah.
I already knew that. Sorry, they put that right there. Just when they're trying to kill me. Well, tonight we're here to lift up and glorify the name of the Lord. That's what we do everywhere we go. We're here tonight to sing about the hope we have in Jesus.
Oh,
coming back.
Gold City, we're in our 44th year of singing gospel music. God has blessed this group through the years. None of us were on stage 44 years ago. But my dad, Tim Riley, who was the last original member to sing with us, retired back in 2014, but has allowed us the privilege of carrying on this legacy of this Gold City. We're so honored to be able to do that. The guys that you see on the stage, they love the Lord, they love this music, and they love what they do. And I'm honored to be on the stage with everyone. I'm over here playing the piano. This young man does a great job. He does a great job for somebody that's not really with us. He's never been hired. So you can't fire a guy that you never hired. But no, me and Terry were in a group together over 30 years ago. We had a great time. He was funny. Loved being around him. He's one of those people. He's really odd, which makes him funny. I had a lady come up to me a while back. She said, "You know that piano player looks like an accountant." And I said, "Well, it's funny you should say that. Because before he started playing with us, he was an accountant." But me and Terry lost touch. We didn't talk for 30 years, pretty much. Once he left that group we were singing with, I thought he had died. I never heard anything out of him again. About 2.5 years ago, we were singing where we're based out of in Gadsden, Alabama, and Terry came to see us. So that night, I said, "Terry, I'd love for you to come go with us one weekend. We'd have a ball. It'd be great to reconnect." And he said he'd love to. So a couple of weeks later, he came with us. He brought his piano. He played with us. We had a great time. We got home, and I said, "Terry, man, it was great to see you. Great to catch up with you." I said, "We'll have to do this again sometime. I'll call you." He's shown up every single week for 2.5 years. Do you know what? We're glad that he does. Would you make him welcome? He's from Alexandria, Alabama. Mr. Terry Newton. Okay. Sorry, Jeff thought he was next. Sit down, gentlemen. I got that for you. Singing the tenor part for Gold City, Chris has been with us for about a year and a half now, and he's no stranger to this music. Been singing, since he was just a kid. Just a boy. And he said that when he was 9 years old, am I right? He bought his first Gold City cassette with his own money. He has been, he has loved Gold City all his life. And I'll tell you, I've been around Gold City all my life since the very beginning. I was 7 years old when this group started. And I should know everything about Gold City. But he knows everything about Gold City. If you want to know anything about Gold City, what song or what album was the song on, what year did they do this, what were their habits on the bus, how often did they go to the bathroom, any of those questions.
Oh, Lord.
He can answer those questions for you. Chris, he does a great job with Gold City. I know you're enjoying him. He is from Greensboro, North Carolina. How about for Chris Jenkins?
All right.
Got to say one more thing about Chris. People come and go with groups like us. You know, like something different comes along and. But anytime anybody gets on our bus, we usually spend a good bit of time just trying to figure out what bothers them. Because we're going to exploit it. People ask us, how do y'all entertain yourself for all the hours going up and down the road? And it's at each other's expense. That's how we do it. So when we figured out what bothered Chris, we got him all riled up one night. And we noticed that when he gets his feathers ruffled, he starts high talking.
Is that an Indian joke?
What?
No.
Not too.
He brought that up, I didn't. But when we get him all riled up, he starts high talking. He sounds like a cross between Mickey Mouse and Gomer Pyle.
Oh, Lord.
Funny.
Oh, my goodness. Yes, he does.
I just wanted y'all to experience that. Thank you.
Oh, Lord.
Sing the lead for Gold City. He has been with us for coming up on a year here in just a few months. And Josh is from a place called Sand Mountain, Alabama. Anybody here know where that is? You win something tonight. I don't know what. Come back. The Sand Mountain is just a, well, it's a mountain in Alabama where they got the name Sand Mountain. I have no idea because I've never seen any sand up there. But what Sand Mountain is known for is great gospel music. A lot of great gospel singers have come from Sand Mountain. One that I know all of you recognize is Vestman.
Yeah.
And so Josh comes from a long line of great music. He has studied music all of his life. He is an accomplished vocal teacher. He loves working with young people to instill in them a love for this music. And we are so honored to have him. I know you're enjoying him tonight. He's from Boaz, Alabama. Mr. Josh Beamsby. Over here singing the bass for Gold City. I've known Jeff for many, many years. And always, you know, when my dad retired, he always had Jeff in mind to step up and sing his part. And, you know, it was just never the right time. But just over a year ago was the right time. And the Lord worked in him, and he realized that this is where God wanted him. And, you know, Jeff started out as a kid singing tenor. Yeah. And then his family moved up under some power lines.
Yeah. Oh, Lord.
God has blessed him with an incredible talent, and I know that you're enjoying him tonight. He's from Brunswick, Georgia, Mr. Jeff Chapman.
All right.
My name's Daniel Ryan. That's the Lord of Gold City. Glad Gold City came to Iowa. Time.
was written, guys, by a South Carolina native, Sandy Knight. Sandy Knight wrote that song. A lot of great Gold City songs, and Sandy was sent to Gold City over the years. Cherry, I'm going to change things up a little bit. Let's do that other one. In Gold City, this song, in the very early 80s, not long after Gold City got started. I love this song because it talks about the grace of God. And folks, I don't know about you, but if it wasn't for the grace of God, I wouldn't be standing here tonight. I wouldn't be standing here proclaiming that I'm a born-again child of God without the grace of our precious Lord. I don't believe I'll fully be able to ever describe the grace of God until one day I receive my brand new body and our brand new mind. Only then will we fully be able to comprehend God's grace and what He did for us on Calvary's cross and why He did what He did. How He can love an old sinner like me so much that He would send His Son to bleed and die one of the most cruel deaths only to save mankind. I believe there's a song that describes God's grace quite like this one right here, and I want you to listen to the words. Except amazing. Listen.
Yeah.
Hey, that's thinking.
Let me tell you, when he reached downstairs for me.
Yeah.
fire tonight, y'all. Woo! Go City Quartet. Look at that.
Appreciate Rodney Barton.
Man, they're good.
Amen. What about Gold City so far tonight?
All right.
I remember the first time I went to go see Gold City. And let me paint this picture for you. We lived in Charlotte, North Carolina. And Mom and Dad had a little weekend warrior group called the Gospelators. And they loved to sing, but they loved any kind of gospel music. And so anytime it came anywhere close to our house, we were at that concert. And it was being promoted that Gold City was going to be at the Ovens Auditorium in Charlotte, North Carolina. You may not know what that is, but it was a big place at the time in Charlotte, North Carolina. And it was a big deal to go to that concert. I do not remember Mom and Dad buying a ticket to go to this concert, but I know they had to. They were taking tickets at the door. But as a kid, I remember the impression of seeing Brian Free and Ivan Parker, Tim Riley, Michael Finger. What a group they were. And I fell in love as a kid. Now, tonight, my wife and I are sitting up here, and there's some little kids that are close to us. And in my mind, I thought, will they remember coming to this Gold City concert tonight and seeing this lineup of Chris Jenkins, Josh Fuster, and Danny Riley, and Jeff Chapman? Well, you know, I think they probably will remember moments like this with Gold City. And through the years, there have been some great formations of this group, but folks, I think we're seeing one of the best formations they have ever had.